everybody, it's Natasha Brown from Brown's Estate Agents. Today I'm here to talk to you in relation to, do you want to become a landlord for the first time and you want to know some information about it? Well, I've put together five things that you need to know. So becoming a landlord is not just about collecting rent. Landlords have a host of obligations and responsibilities to adhere to. In a time where many landlords are leaving the market, I've put together five things that you need to know before you decide to become a landlord. Number one. If you don't have an agent helping you with the property, you must juggle many tasks and know your responsibilities. Before you take on the role of becoming a landlord, you need to take a step back and think about the role itself and what it entails. You'll need to be available to tend to issues that tenants may have. They can often be repairs that need to be done immediately, such as blocked pipework or broken windows. You should also be prepared to maintain a positive and professional relationship with your tenants. You'll be their main point of contact for any issues they have in relation to their tenancy, so make sure you have good communication. A landlord will have many tasks to deal with when renting their property, some of which include the following: advertising the property, salesperson, rent collection, repair and maintenance, regular inspections, and RTB registration. Number two, there are legal rules you must abide to. There are many rules that landlords must follow, and it would be wise for you as a landlord to familiarise yourself with them. As a landlord, you cannot enter the home without the tenant's permission. You must organise a day and time to suit both of you and the tenant and then call. Many areas now have a 4% rental increase cap in place, meaning that rent reviews in those areas cannot go higher than 4% of the previous rent. A landlord can go to the RTB website and use the rental calculator, place the address in along with a few other bits of information, and the calculator will tell you the rental increase allowed. Number three, minimum standards and safety regulations for all rental properties. This is really important. A landlord must also know the minimum standards and safety regulations for a rental property. A tenant has the right to contact the RTB if they believe their property does not comply. Some minimum standards include: the property must be free from damp and in good structural repair. All rooms have adequate ventilation and heating. They must be a supply of hot and cold water. All appliances in good working order. Each house must have a fire blanket and fire detection alarm along with other ones. The more can be found at RTB website. Number four, insurance on your property is important. When it comes to your rental property, it may be worth thinking about getting it insured. In the unforeseen event something may happen to the property, you will be at financial loss. If you have furniture in the property yourself, you could get contents cover. There are plenty of insurance companies that you can speak to in relation to the best options for you and your property. Number five, it can be satisfying renting your property. When you decide to rent your property, you can build a good relationship with your tenants. The fact that you can provide a home for another human being is very satisfying. Even now, in times that have been so tough for everybody with COVID-19, many landlords have stepped up and helped their tenants out. And it's in times like this that we really see how good landlords can actually be to their tenants. Many landlords have great tenants and tenants that have been in place for years and treated the house like their own. And they stay in the property because the landlord is happy with them. This guidance is only for general purposes only. If you'd like more information in relation to becoming a landlord for the first time, I'm happy to help. You can give me a call or you can give us a like and subscribe and leave a comment down below if you'd like me to get back in touch with you. Thanks a million and thanks for watching.